One person keeping a close eye on the federal response, Louisiana Senator Bill Cassidy.
Yes, Senator Cassidy joining us this morning. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. So first question, what is the big message you want to give to the public regarding this coronavirus outbreak?
Stay at home. You can help prevent, of course we're here, right? But we're trying to get our social distancing. You can help prevent the spread by just not coming in contact with other people. And if you do, maintain that distance. I keep on telling people, don't touch me. because I don't think I'm infected. I don't think you're infected, but there might be a chance, in which case you give it to me, I give it, boom, 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 and we can continue to spread it to others.
But you travel a lot. You've been up in Washington. Have you been tested?
I have not been tested. I've not been symptomatic. I will be going to Washington today. Frankly, I think that we should begin to meet remotely in the Senate, but at least there we've let go all the staff. Except for like 20 people, and we can maintain social distancing, so I will be as far away from Mitch McConnell or Chuck Schumer as I am from you.
Yeah, we hear a lot, Bill, from the president and from the task force talking about flattening the curve. You're a doctor. You've been down in the trenches in the fight against viruses in your career. How do you flatten the curve? What's your message?
So the word is, so if you have this many hospital beds and you get everybody sick within 3 weeks, everybody's sick within 3 weeks, you have this many hospital beds, you run out of beds, and people die literally because you don't have a bed for them. If you stretch it out from 3 weeks to 6 months, and then you have this long, slow curve, you always have enough hospital beds at every point along the way. That's why we want to flatten the curve.
Do you think we have enough hospital beds here in Louisiana?
So right now, some projections are that we will run out by the end of April, I think, if we don't flatten the curve. Mm-hmm. That we have there's a shortage of ventilators around the country. The president has spoken about that, a shortage of ICU beds. I know one thing, the governor's task force, they're looking for beds wherever they might be and standing them back up. We might flatten the curve.
Mm-hmm. Now, we've been watching everything play out in Italy. We know that there's now these international, we're being cut off from certain countries, UK, Ireland, that goes into effect tonight. Are we looking at a domestic travel ban here in country, or maybe a quarantine of the U.S.?
The president has spoken of that. Right now, there's a hot spot in Washington State and obviously New York City. But we really have to assume that most places have a significant number of cases. They are just a few weeks ahead of us. The president has not yet announced that ban. I think when you travel now, you'll find plenty of room between you and the next person. So he's not yet announced. He might announce. In the meantime, I bring hand wipes. I wipe down my desk. I wipe down the bed. I wipe down the arms, and I have hand sanitizer.
Yeah, we've got some right here.
We wiped down this set this morning, yeah.
And then you wipe down your phone.
Absolutely.
Now, over the last week, testing has been a huge concern. I know yesterday when Louisiana's numbers were updated, CDC has still only confirmed 2 of the 200-something tests that had been sent out. Any concern from a federal response level on testing and getting those positive tests and getting confirmation on how many people actually test positive for coronavirus?
Well, if somebody needs, I saw this morning that no longer will the CDC demand that there be a backup test. So if you're initially diagnosed as positive, it presumes that it's a positive. Second thing I've learned is that you can go to the doctor, your normal doctor, and he or she does not need to send it to the CDC. They can send it to LabCorp, or they can send it to Quest or someplace else that can run it commercially. So there will be expanded testing. I know the governor's office, I believe, is going to have some announcements as to further provision of testing that will be available. If your doctor recommends you get it, you should get it.
One last question. You know, people are scared. Many people are out there. We saw over the weekend almost panic buying, just stocking up on stuff. The president said, please relax, don't hoard, buy, that kind of thing. What's your message to people out, given we're going through these extraordinary times?
Yeah, so this is different than a hurricane. In a hurricane, you don't have, your supply chain is messed up. Walmart, Bedar, they can't get the groceries there. Here, they can get the groceries there. So just give it a day or two, and that stuff will flow in. There's no need to hoard. Eat at home or have somebody deliver to you, but at the same time, you don't need to have closets full of toilet paper.
Perfect. Senator Bill Cassidy, thanks for joining us, and look, we invite you to come back during when all this, as this unfolds.
That'll be great. Or we can also Skype if I'll be from D.C.
Absolutely, we'll do it.
Okay, thank you.
All right, Bill, thank you so much.